Hi friends, welcome back to Mangalorean Taste Buds by Asha. Today I'll show you how I make Aloo Matar Pulao or Bachelor Pulao. This is a very simple one pot recipe for lunch boxes or for those lazy weekdays. We call this lazy day because it is so simple to make and you can make it with simple ingredients that are easily available in our pantry. Aloo Matar Pulao tastes great with any veggie curry like kormas, meat or chicken curries, or just plain cucumber raita as an accompaniment. This makes it in our lunchbox very often, so no messy tiffins with the side of yogurt, pickle and peppered. So let's check out the ingredients. If you are new to my channel, a warm welcome. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, please do subscribe. If you like this recipe of mine, do give a thumbs up and click the like button. If you have tried this recipe, please leave a comment in the comment section below. So let's get started. Here I have taken one large onion sliced, 2 teaspoons of ginger, garlic, green chilli and coriander crushed, 1 tomato chopped fine. You can use ginger garlic paste and chopped green chilies also. Here I have taken ghee, you can use oil also, 1 teaspoon of cumin seeds, 1/2 teaspoon of peppercorns. Once cumin and peppercorn crackle, add the sliced onion and fry till it is nice and soft and transparent. You need not brown the onions. Once this is nice and soft, you can add the crushed. I have added around 1/2 teaspoon of asafoetida. This is optional, but you can add it. Add the crushed ginger, garlic, green chili and coriander paste, or you can make it into a fine paste or you can use it separately. Add 1 bay leaf, add the chopped tomatoes. Fry it well. Add salt as per taste. This is 1 potato and 1/2 cups or 1/2 cup of green peas. This is frozen. This is ordinary rice. I have not used basmati rice. This is the kolam or sona masuri, what you call it. 1/4 pinch of turmeric powder. Now add the peas and potatoes. Give it a nice good mix and cook till the potatoes are 25% done. It will take around 5 to 7 minutes. Once you see the potatoes are 25 to 30% done, then add the rice and give it a good mix. You can use basmati rice also. Since I have taken 1 cup of rice, I add 2 cups of water. Give it a nice mix. At this point of time, check out the salt. If required, add it and cook till the water evaporates. Once the water evaporates, then keep it on the slowest flame for another couple of minutes. By now the rice is ready. You can cook it in a pressure cooker if you wish. Thanks for watching. Please like, share and subscribe to my channel and do not forget to click the bell icon to get notified as and when I upload a new recipe. The list of ingredients is given in the description box below. So my dear friends, hope you have enjoyed this quick and yummy recipe. Stay tuned for more such interesting recipes. Till we meet again, check out my other recipes at Mangalorean Taste Buds by Asha. Bye, see you soon with a new interesting recipe. Take care.